thank you for tuning in again. I'm Nicholas Miyagua for the third tutorial. In the last tutorial, we talked about softwares. Now we are starting about hardwares. What is the meaning of the term hardware? In your normal life, hardware is the shop where you can buy cement and those materials used in construction. Now, in ICT, hardware refers to the physical components of a computer. Remember, a computer system is made up of different components which work together to process data and information. Under the components of a computer system, we shall talk about hardware, software, humanware, data, and the procedures. Let us begin with hardware refers to the physical and the tangible components of a computer system. For example, any part which you can touch on the computer is termed to be hardware. Today, we have different types of hardwares. We have the keyboards, the mice, the flash, and all of those. They are grouped, they are classified and categorized into different classes. We have the input hardwares, the processing hardwares, the storage hardwares, among others. We are going to start with the processing hardwares. The major use of a computer is to process data into information. Therefore, there is a component which is used to process the data into information. And this component is what we call a processor. A processor is a silicon chip. It is an integrated circuit, meaning various transistors were packed together onto a small chip to form a processor. The common processors we have today are the Pentium, the AMDs, the Motorola's. Normally we call them the 86 classes of processors. However, today we also have the 64 compatible processors. What are the parts of a processor? Inside, a processor is made up of different parts which are used to convert the data you have into the information which you can understand. Among these components, we have the control unit. This is the most important part into the CPU. The control unit is the one which controls all the operations of other hardware components of a computer, including other parts of the processor itself. The control unit does the fetching and the decoding. What is to fetch? Whenever you press a button on the keyboard, that button, that keystroke is transferred to the memory. It is the work of the control to fetch the data, decode it, such that the processor can understand it and interpret it. Therefore, the process of fetching means getting data from the source. Decoding means converting the data into a form which a CPU can understand, which the other parts can understand. Decoding involves converting data from the itself form into the binary form which a CPU can execute. What is execution? Execution basically means adding, multiplying, and doing the real job. Now, after the control has fetched the data and has decoded it, it sends it to the arithmetic logical unit, the ARL. The ARL is made up of two components, the arithmetic part and the logical part. The arithmetic part is generally responsible for adding, for multiplying, it for executing the job. Say if you want to say 2 plus 2, 2 is the data which was fetched. This plus is the operator which tells the ALU, which tells the arithmetic unit how to manipulate this data to get the answer 4. Now this answer 4 you are getting is the result, is the information, is the result of execution. After there, we have the logical part. This unit is responsible for comparing the result and the original data. That's why we have operators like equals, greater than, less than, not equal, and all of those are part of the logical operators. Now, where we have the logical and the arithmetic, we form the ARU. Because if I say 2, which is data, plus 2, which is data, this plus is the arithmetic operator. Now, I need the equal sign to get the answer for. So the equal sign is comparing the data and the information. That gives us the ALU. So every task that is being done in a computer, it is executed by the ALU. And the ALU cannot execute it before the control has fetched it and decoded it. Another part is the registers. What is a register? A register is a part of the CPU which holds the data that is going to be processed. Data which is being processed is held at the registers. A register can work as a plate. When you go to the kitchen to get food, you don't take your mouth to put the food there. No, you go with the plate. Much as the food is going to be eaten by you by putting it in your mouth, you don't go with the mouth. You take the plate. Therefore, the plate is holding the food which you are eating. Therefore, a plate is what we call the register. Under the registers, we've got different memories. So a register itself is a memory which holds information, which holds the data and instructions that are being worked upon. Then, we have the cache memory. Cache is a fast memory, which is fast meaning speed. It is either located on the CPU itself or outside, like on the RAM or a dedicated chip on the motherboard. What is a cache? A cache stores instructions which are accessed recently. For example, if you are dialing a number, if you call somebody, after calling, the number is going to be saved in the received, in the dialed, in the missed calls. So that part is what we call the cache, because the data is already stored on the memory. However, the CPU holds it again in the caches, and the cache has two levels. The level one, which is on the CPU itself, level two sometimes is also on the CPU, then other levels like a 3-4, it can be a dedicated chip on the motherboard or on RAM itself. Then we have what we call the buffer. A buffer is also a memory. Its work is to act as a clutch. You see, when you are riding a motorcycle, whenever you want to change the gear, you hold the clutch. Okay? So this clutch enables a smooth transition from one gear to another. Now, if your processor has finished processing, it is trying to send the information to the printer to be output. The printer cannot receive all the job at once. It is going to first hold it at the buffer, so that it can access it job by job, page per page. So the buffer holds information that is either coming from out input or that is going to the output. It bridges the gap between the input and the output. So information that is yet to be output is first stored into the buffers, and we call it the output buffer. Information that is coming in is kept at also the buffer, and we call it the input buffer. The CPU also has got what you call the clock, the system clock. What is a clock? This is made up of a vibrating quartz crystal, and it sets the pace at which the CPU is going to work. It sets the pace at which the data is going to be processed. It's like the ticking clock, okay? Whenever it ticks, it means an instruction is executed. Now, the number of cycles completed within a tick, within a second, is measured as a frequency. We term it to be a hertz. Meaning, if one cycle is completed within a second, that is 1 hertz. If 100 cycles are completed within a second, we take that to be 100 hertz. If it is 1,000 cycles within a second, we take it to be 1 kilohertz. If it is 1,000,000, we call it 1,000,000 hertz, MHZ. Then if it is 1,000,000,000, we say it is 1 gigahertz, like that and so on. So the clock, the system clock is important. It determines the speed at which the computer is going to operate. After there, we shall look at the MIPS or MIPS. MIPS is a unit of measuring the speed of computer, the rate at which instructions are completed. If within a second, 1,000,000 instructions are completed, then the speed of a processor is 1,000,000 instructions per second. If it is 2, then the speed will be 2 million instructions per second, 2 MPIS. That is the processor. So in this lesson, we've looked at the processor, the work of a processor, and the parts including the ALU, registers, control unit, the system clock, cache, and the buffers. Thank you for being with us.